Now for the hole tuck pattern, I'm going to have both tuck buttons pushed in. I want to make sure the AB dial is to A. I'm going to select the needles, knit across. I'm going to put the AB over to B, select the needles, knit across. Back to A, select the needles, knit across. Back to B, select the needles, knit across. And you keep doing that for as long as you need. Now you could do a combination of tuck and hold. Basically kind of the same idea, but where this machine is set up to do it, you're going to take your left cam lever and put it up to 3. You're going to push your right tuck button in. The right cam lever is down to 1. And that's all. Well, you have buttons 1, 3, 5, and 7 in again. You're going to select the needles. The AB switch is on A. You're going to knit 2 rows. So that would be the hold. Now when I come back, it's going to tuck. I'm going to select the needles again. I do not have to do anything else. Push the carriage across and back. Select the needles. Knit across and back. And you do that for as long as you need with this design. So there is the partial tuck. There is the full tuck. This is the tuck and hold. When I first got this machine, and I would take these levers, the lay-in levers, and I moved one, the brush underneath just crumbled. It's so old, there was no way of saving it. So now I went to the hardware store and I found these, which I believe is a rivet. One side does look like a rivet, but the other side has threads to where the second part screws in. But I also need a washer because even as small as that is, I needed that little bit extra. So I took one of the bottom plates off just so you could see what I'm doing here. Now I already replaced the other side here. And the wheel does turn. So you don't have to take the bottom part off, but you're going to take the outside screw off and loosen the inside screw to this brush here. You need to get this part out. Then I have the thicker part that has the threads on the inside. I put the washer on there. I put the brush. Now this is not the correct brush, but it is a round brush and I'm sure it'll still work. I put that over it. And then I took the screw and started screwing it in. But then now, so this goes like that. So I need the part with the screw. So that the screw, if I was to do this other side here, it doesn't go down all the way. But if I'm to take this side with the screw, it does go down all the way. Then I need to tighten up this screw. And there, it's locked in place now. So now to get it back, you're going to take and put this behind the metal of the brush that's in the carriage already, or sinker plate. And there's a little tab that fits in a slot, a little tab on this metal part here that fits in a slot on this piece here. And then there's a little screw that I need to get started on the front again. Well, let me make sure I got that lined up. There, I need to have that knob at N. Yeah. So that will go back in place. And it looks like it's lined up. So I could try again. That's one thing with magnetized screwdrivers. Sometimes it doesn't always work the way you want it to. Okay, so let me try that. I'm holding this brush back by the corner. There we go. Okay, so it started. I could go ahead and tighten that up. Tighten the other screw up. And you're all done. Of course, you wouldn't have this undone. I just need to put this back on is all. But now, this little lever works, and that brush is in place, and it does turn. So let me try it out on the machine. Well, after I put that other part back on. It's actually working up pretty good. So the way you set up the carriage is you take these two levers here, you put them to T, you put these levers or buttons to T, and that pushes those brushes down as I've shown. You're going to have your main yarn in the carriage. Now, when I've done weaving before, I have a thin yarn in the carriage and a little thicker yarn for weaving. You're going to, now on this machine, when the carriage is on the right, I have the dial set to A. I move the lever to select the needles. Now, I do have to push back that end one, the fabric right there. But I lay the other yarn, the weaving yarn, or lay-in yarn, as this manual tells you, over the hooks. I knit across. Sometimes easier said than done. Okay, so I'm going to take that button, put it, the AB, put it to B, select those needles. Now, before when I had this problem, it got a little tight, so I had to make sure, and it did get tight right there in that part there, but this is just a little sample, so no big deal right now. If you're actually working on a garment, you may have to undo a couple rows of this just to get it back good. Lay in yarn over the hooks, or weave in yarn over the hooks, knit across. Put the AB switch back to A, move the lever over, lay the yarn over the hooks. And I see again, it is a little tight right there. So I just make sure those needles are in good position. That was a little bit better. Back to B, select the needles, lay the yarn over. As you see, the needles are in good position there. Knit across. Back to A, select the needles, move the yarn, lay the yarn over the hooks, knit across, and that's all there is to weaving. Let me zoom in on this so you could see. Actually, I could see where it's tight in there on the green and tight over here on the green, but right in here is what it should look like. So here and over here, you could see how that's supposed to look and where the stitches were tight. Well, I should have undone or ripped back a row or two. to make sure that was working right, for some reason, it knitted the green stitches a little too tight there. So now to do a little different pattern on this weave in. I have buttons 1, 3, and 5 in. Instead of moving the AB knob back from A to B, I'm going to be moving the left to right. When you look at the left side, there is, under the pattern center here, you got left, a down arrow, which points to 1 through 8, and then the right and a right arrow. So, first of all, I need to select my needles. I am going to lay the weaving yarn over the hooks, and I need to put these side levers to T and the front buttons to T and knit across. Now I'm going to move this one over, so now the down arrow was pointing to 2. And basically, like I mentioned before, that's just changing the number 1 needle is all. So I'm going to take, lay the yarn over the hooks, knit across. Again, I'm going to turn the left right over 1 so it's on 3. Select the needles, lay the yarn over the hooks. One more time to 4. Select the needles, lay the yarn over the hooks, knit across. And now I'm going to work backwards. So I just keep an eye on that arrow. Now it's on 3 again. Select the needles, lay the yarn, knit across. Back over to 2. Select the needles, lay the yarn, knit across. Back to 1, select the needles, lay the yarn, knit across. And I could actually just keep going back and forth. I could even go 1 through 8 and then back to 1. It's really up to you on what you want to do with this. I'm just going by what was in the manual. And there you go. Of course, you have the first part I did down here, but this is what I just did by moving the pattern center left and right.